احنا جينا جينا احنا جينا جينا
احنا جينا جينا احنا جينا جينا احنا جينا جينا احنا جينا جينا احنا جينا جينا احنا جينا جينا
احنا جينا وترى الشوق دفعنا احنا جينا والامل في لقاكم
احنا جينا وترى الشوق دفعنا احنا جينا والامل في لقاكم
يا عسى الله على الحب يجمعنا عسى الله على الحب يجمعنا
نطلب الله الرضا ثم رضاكم
نطلب الله الرضا ثم رضاكم قيمة محمد المسيح
إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ثم أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد إخواني وأخواتي في الله My dear brothers and my dear sisters في الجمعة الماضية تكلمنا عن القلب السليم Last Friday we spoke about القلب السليم The safe and secure and guarded heart. That heart, my dear brothers and sisters, as we mentioned last Friday, هذا القلب معلق في الله سبحانه وتعالى وترك الدنيا وما بها. That heart is attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Left behind all those materialistic life, worldly things, and whatever attract him or deceive him in the dunya. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those people they having this kind of heart. Ameen. And my dear brothers and sisters, also we spoke about this kind of characteristics of this type of heart. أَمَّا الْيَوْمِ فسنتكلم عن النوع الثاني من أنواع القلوب. Today we will speak about the second type of hearts. And that type هو القلب السقيم أو المريض. This kind of heart, the second type, it is the sick heart. May Allah protect us from this kind of heart. Sick heart. Not attached 100% in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there is an attachment. Not attached to with the dunya 100%, but there is attachment. So this kind of heart, like many of us maybe, my dear brothers and sisters, there is attachment to Allah and attachment to the dunya. تَعَلُّقٌ فِي اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَتَعَلُّقٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا like كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ. My dear brothers and sisters, هذا القلب اعترته الذنوب أو احتلته أو سيطرت عليه أحيانا. This kind of heart occupied, controlled by many of the sins or mistakes or fault. My dear brothers and sisters, كل ابن آدم خطاء. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, all mankind, all human beings making mistakes, committing sin, did something intentionally or unintentionally that is wrong. But is normal, this my dear brothers and my dear sisters. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ. Look at this oath. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one he own and control the soul of him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, the soul of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, by Allah, the one he control my soul. He said, لَوْ لَمْ تُذْنِبُوا لَذَهَبَ اللَّهُ بِكُمْ. If you don't make mistakes, if you don't committing a sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you away completely. وَلَجَاءَ بِقَوْمٍ يُذْنِبُونَ. And Allah will bring nation, people, they will committing sin, making mistakes, making some kind of faults. فَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهِ فَيَغْفِرَ لَهُمْ. And then we'll ask Allah for forgiveness, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will forgive them. But does not mean, my dear brothers and sisters, we'll challenging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with our sins. كثيرا من الناس ما يضل الطريق. A lot of people, they will mislead the road or the way or as الطريق المستقيم, the straight path. ولذلك فتح الله لنا أبواب المغفرة والرحمة. For this reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened for us the gates, the doors of forgiveness and maghfirah and mercy, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. Adam, Abu al-Bashar, Adam, the father of a human being, mankind, the first man that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created, he's our father. Also he committed the sin when he ate from that tree. As shaitan, Iblis, the Satan, my dear brothers and sisters, the one he deceived Adam alayhi salam, he told Allah, أن ينظره إلى يوم القيامة. Give him a chance to live until the day of judgment. فأعطاه الله سبحانه وتعالى ذلك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him, give Iblis, the Satan, this chance to live. But his oath to mislead all mankind, to mislead all human beings, except there is an exception. We are lucky, my dear brothers and sisters, there is an exception. إِلَّا عِبَادِ اللَّهِ الصَّالِحِينَ. Except the pious Muslims and pious believers. May Allah make us among those people. But he, Iblis, he said, and he's making an oath, قسم. And listen to this قسم, my dear brothers and sisters, this oath. قال وعزتك. He swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at that. قال وعزتك وجلالك. By your glory, by your power, ya Allah. لا خرجت من قلبي ابن آدم ما دامت فيه الروح. لا خرجت. He said, I swear by your glory, by your power, I'm not going to leave the son of Adam. I'm not going to leave him as far as there is a soul in him. That means as far as he's still alive, I'm not going to leave him. Look at that challenge. Look at this challenge. That means he is our enemy since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam until today, until tomorrow, until the day of judgment. See, my dear brothers and sisters,
What Allah Azza wa Jal replied to him? قَالَ وَعِزَّتِي وَجَلَالِي. My glory and my power. Allah Azza wa Jal swear by Himself. وَعِزَّتِي وَجَلَالِي لَا حَجَبْتُ عَنْهُ التَّوْبَةِ مَا دَامَتْ فِيهِ الرُّوحِ. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى, I'm not going to stand between him and the repentance as far as he's still alive. Look at this chance. The doors of the tawbah, the gates of the repentance, the gates of mercy, my dear brothers and sisters, still open. Even if we have some sickness inside our heart. My dear brothers and sisters, this kind of heart, as I mentioned, not qalb salim, is not a secure and safe and attached to Allah Azza wa Jal all the time. There is some kind of ghafla, unawareness, attachment to the dunya. And as I said, all of us making mistakes. My dear brothers and sisters, our heart supposed to be يحضر الآخرة ويرجو رحمة الله سبحانه وتعالى. We are afraid from Allah. We are afraid from the hereafter. We are afraid from Jahannam. But still, I want you, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يحضر الآخرة. We are aware, we are afraid. ولكن يرجو رحمة الله سبحانه وتعالى. You are hoping to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Does not mean, my dear brothers and sisters, we deceive ourselves. Like for example, yesterday one of the brothers said, I stay until 2 o'clock in the morning making da'wah online. Making da'wah. To make da'wah, my dear brothers and sisters, that is the most beautiful things. But to make da'wah online and then you miss Salat al-Fajr, that wal'iyadu billah is a great sin. Da'wah is good. Missing Fajr is a great sin. Great sin. Missing any salah is a great sin, my dear brothers and sisters. Intentionally, missing salah. Intentionally. That kufr wal'iyadu billah. May Allah protect us from that. So, let your heart attach to Allah. Attach to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not sick. And as I said, all of us we get sick. All of us, we have this kind of weakness in the heart. But does not mean this weakness will be forever. As I mentioned last Friday, my dear brothers and sisters, just a reminder. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this heart, the heart of mankind, when we make sin, when we committing a sin, there is a dark dot will be in the heart. Dark dot. But when we ask Allah for forgiveness and istighfar, this dot will be erased. Then the heart will become a light, white, clear, attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again. But when we forget to ask Allah for forgiveness, and we're committing another sin, and we don't ask Allah for forgiveness, and the third one, and so on. May Allah protect us from that. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it will be a layer of rust. A layer of rust over the heart. Over the heart. That's me, my dear brothers and sisters, we're not going to see the truth, the reality. That's what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell. And وَذَلِكَ الرَّان. And that is the ran, the rust. May Allah protect us from that. So my dear brothers and sisters, another example of this kind of heart. And the man, one man, he used to work an iron smith, blacksmith. Blacksmith, as you know, you have to deal with fire and iron and melt the iron. And so you have to wear gloves. And this is gloves to protect you from the fire. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, a neighbor for that iron or blacksmith, he saw the blacksmith holding the fire by his own bare hands. Holding the hot iron with his own hands. You wonder what kind of hands this man has. Is it strange? My dear brothers and sisters, he wondered and he went to ask him. He asked him, what happened? How you have this kind of hand and a fire cannot touch you? قال والله, I have a story. a story. A female relative. Female came to ask for money, for loan. For loan. And I told her, I give you the loan when you give me a chance with you. She refused. Until her kids almost died. And then my dear brothers and sisters, she came to him and she accept. And he accept to give her 1,000 dinar. And we, that is a sick heart. Completely sick heart, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. And then when they went to his house, to the room, she said, غلق الأبواب, close the doors. قال أغلقتها. I closed all the doors. And she said, one door still open. And he said, what do you mean? قال باب الواحد الديان الذي لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. The door of الديان, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today, and the one he never sleep or feel sleep. And the man said, وبردت وبردت شهوتي. My desire comes very cold. And was so afraid. And I give her the money. And I didn't see anything of that woman. وقلت لها, and I said to her, استغفر الله لي. استغفر الله لي. Ask Allah to forgive me. And she said to him, اللهم حرم النار عليه في الدنيا والآخرة. Oh Allah, protect him from the fire in the dunya and in the akhirah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make me able to hold the fire in the dunya. And I ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect me from the fire in the hereafter. Look at that, my dear brothers and sisters. His heart was sick. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make his heart alive again. Salim, attached to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, this is the second type of heart. The third type of heart. May Allah protect us from second and third. The third one is al-qalbu al-mayyit, the dead heart. The dead heart. This man, my dear brothers and sisters, to give an advice or not to give an advice, he is always attached to the dunya. Materialistic life, worldly things, subhanallah. And when you come to him, and please give attention to this. Say, person, brother, so and so, come to the masjid, or pray, or give salah, or make salah. And he said, my heart is clean, pure. I don't have to make the salah. I don't have time for the salah. I don't have time for this. A woman without hijab, but she's a Muslim. She's a Muslim, put hijab. I say, I don't have to, as far as my heart attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is qalbun sick. It's a sick heart, my dear brothers and sisters. May Allah protect us from that. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, يأتي على أمتي, it will time come upon my ummah, يحبون خمسا وينسون خمسا. It will time come upon my ummah. They will love five things and they will forget five things. Five things they will love so much. What is this five things? Number one, يحبون المخلوق وينسون الخالق. They will love the creation, each other, kids, wife, husband, daughters, father, mother. They will be attached to the creation, to each other, but they forget the one he create all those creations. May Allah protect us from that. يحبون المال وينسون الحساب. They will love to collect money, wealth, to be rich, and they will forget that will be responsible for every single penny they collected. Even if you collected in a halal way. Even if you collect this in halal, Allah Azza wa Jal said, Surah Al-Ahzab, وَلْيَسْأَلَ الصَّادِقِينَ عَنْ صِدْقِهِمْ. Ya Allah, Allah will ask the truthful, why they are truthful? Why you pray Jum'ah? Do you have an answer, my dear brothers and sisters? If you have an answer, you are on the safe side. That's why the Prophet said they will love money, wealth, collecting the money.
And they will forget that Allah will ask about every single penny. How you gain the money and how you spend the money. Number three, يحبون القصور وينسون القبور. يحبون, they love castles, big houses, even if that house with mortgage, with riba, with interest, and they will forget al-qubur, the graves. That means any big house or castle you will build, when you die, you will be in a small box or a small hole, dark, without even pillow, without even blanket, without even light, without even nothing except sand around you and in the top of you. May Allah protect us from that. But we're gonna be there sooner or later. But it is in your hand to make this grave part of the Jannah. Part of the Jannah. When your qalb and your heart is saleem, secure, attached to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make us among those people. Number three, number four, يحبون الدنيا وينسون الآخرة. They love dunya, materialistic life, worldly things, and they will forget they're gonna be in the akhirah, between the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sooner or later. The last one, يحبون الذنوب وينسون التوبة. They love to committing sin, but they forget to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for repentance. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from that, my dear brothers and sisters. The door of the Jannah, the door of Maghfirah, the doors of mercy opened in the day and the night. This moment and the second is still open as far as you're still alive. Take advantage. Take advantage of this, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us the Jannah, the paradise. Udu'u Allah wa antum muqinuna bil ijabah. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, جلس الصحابة يوما حول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يستفتونه. The صحابة, the companions, sit around the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brother, turn your phone off. Wallahi, it's haram to make any business inside the masjid during Salat al-Jum'ah. Wallahi, it's haram for your phone to ring in a matter of business in time of the Salat al-Jum'ah. Haram, my dear brothers and sisters. And I mean it, and I mentioned this last Friday. It's haram, the meaning of haram. Because you're not going to answer the phone. If you answer the phone, your Jum'ah is not valid anymore. You are here in the house of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let your heart attach to Him. Only Him. Only Him. It's not going to make any difference when you come to the masjid, inshallah, this next Friday. And leave your phone inside the car, not inside the masjid. Inside the car, inshallah. Have this intention. And I am sure 100%, if you think you're going to lose business, and you leave your phone in the car for the sake of Him, only Him, Allah, I am sure Allah will multiply your business, inshallah, and make you one of the best, bi-idhnillahi rabbil alameen. Say inshallah in your heart and apply it in your life, inshallah. I'm so sorry to say that, but it's hurting when you are in the masjid, in the Jum'ah, and not only that, sometimes the phone rings with the music. Let's speak about the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Sahaba sit around the Prophet, ask him, who is Messenger of Allah? Who is the best among the people? Who is the best among the people? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best among the people, كُلُّ مَخْمُومِ الْقَلْبَ صَدُوقِ اللِّسَانِ. أَفْضَلِ النَّاسِ The one makhmoom, have a genuine heart, raw heart, and saying the truth. قالوا يا رسول الله أما صدوق اللسان فنعرفه. The one he's saying the truth, we know who is saying the truth. فما مخموم القلب. What is that word مخموم, genuine or pure? القلب. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم هو التقي النقي الذي لا غل فيه ولا حسد. التقي, the one have a تقوى, piety, God fearing. النقي, have a clean heart from any kind of hate or envy. And he says صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي لا غل فيه, there is no hatred, no transgression, and no hasad, no evil eye. With those 3 minutes, my dear brothers and sisters, there is six points will help us, all of us, inshallah rabbil alameen, to have our heart safe, secured, guarded, saleem, good heart. Number one, my dear brothers and sisters, may Allah help us for number one and number six too, and all of us, ameen. هي number one, الصلة بذكر الله وقراءة القرآن. Always make your tongue repeating Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tasbih, dhikr, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is make your life and your heart alive all the time. Number two, my dear brothers and sisters, الدُّعَاء. Always make dua. It's not a shame to make dua. In fact, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ادعوني, he said, ادعوني, an order for us. And he said, and he replied to us, قال أستجب لكم. I will give you what you want. But make sure to make the dua, eat halal. Eat halal. Drink halal. Wear halal. Live in halal in order for your dua to be accepted, inshaAllah. Number three, الرقابة على خواطر القلوب ومحاسبة النفس. To watch over your heart, your thinking. And the most important thing, hold yourself accountable. Hold yourself accountable, محاسبة. In this case, my dear brothers and sisters, if you hold ourselves accountable today, in there, our محاسبة, our scale, it will be known, because you hold yourself, you are the judge. No one else can judge you in the dunya but yourself. Number four, المجاهدة. المجاهدة, strive against evil, my dear brothers and sisters. And the most important thing, strive against within yourself. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانِ وَنَعْلَمُ ما توسوس به نفسه ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد. Allah Azza wa Jal said, we laqad, indeed, for sure, we created mankind, human being. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانِ وَنَعْلَمُ, and we know, Allah Azza wa Jal said, we know what his own self whispers to him. Talking to yourself, Allah knows exactly what you are talking to yourself. مُجَاهَدَة. You have to strive so hard in the life to have your heart saleem, secure, safe, guarded, inshaAllah. Number five, اجتناب المعاصي وحماية النفس منها. To be avoiding anything will lead you to the haram. And I'm advising my dear brothers and sisters, especially for those people chatting all day, all night, or making da'wah even online. That is an evil thing. And we think it's good. But we have to be careful. We didn't say it's bad. I wouldn't say it's good 100%. But you are the judge. Number six, my dear brother and sister, the last one, Al-Ikhlas. Al-Ikhlas. Every action, everything you do, everything, you need to be sincere to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Loyal to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only for him. My dear brothers and sisters, and those things, with all my advice and advise myself first, we're not going to learn it hard outside the masjid, only in his house, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The house of Allah, our iman going up. Outside the house of Allah, our iman going down. as him, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الْإِيمَانِ يَزِيدُ وَيَنْقُصُ. Al-Iman yazid, increase when you are in the act of worship, and decrease when you are out of the act of worship. May Allah help us for that, my dear brothers and sisters. But I want you to think for a moment. You are the judge. What kind of heart do you have? What kind of heart? Salim, safe, secure, attached to Allah, or sick? Maybe sickness, and I can make it good, bi-idhnillah, or dead. May Allah protect us from the last one. Be a judge, and be fair with yourself, and hold yourself accountable before Allah will hold us accountable. Allahumma inna nas'aluka imanan da'ima.
Deny the oneness of Allah. Allahu Akbar. How can you deny the oneness of Allah? Allahu Akbar. How can you deny the oneness of Allah? Allahu Akbar. How can you deny the oneness of Allah? Allahu Akbar.